can't make serious music. It's always Jackie, that's a joke. Jackie, make us laugh. It's never Jackie, sing us a song, make beautifully.
Well, here we go again.
Time to tidy up for all the high and mighty folks. King may toil from sun to sun, but a peasant's work is never done.
How true. Just look at these candles. I put them in only yesterday, and now there's almost nothing left.
It's the same with the firewood. Every day, I drive in loads and loads of firewood, and every day, they just burn them up.
Well, it's the same with the food. Every day, I bring in platters and trays loaded with food. And guess what they do?
What?
They eat them all up.
Amazing.
Astounding.
Remarkable.
Good grief, what a sound.
What was that?
Sounded like a sick dog.
No, it was only Jack the Jester.
Oh, I should have guessed.
Send a song.
Move your feet and your lute. I have to sweep under here.
Can you just skip it?
No, the old queen always notices everything.
She doesn't like dust.
And she won't like her song either.
She never has any appreciation for my music.
And neither does anyone else.
Better put that lute away, Jester. The queen... Oh.
The king will be here any moment.
And the old queen, too.
I'm telling you, it's my turn to open the book to you.
It is not!
A member of my family always opens the book on odd number years.
Well, a member of my family always opens the book on even number years.
Well, a member of my family always opens the book on all the other years.
Right.
Well, what year is this?
Begging pardon, lordships, but why don't you just look at a calendar?
Good idea, Alfred. Alfred, do we
have a calendar? Don't ask me.
How are we supposed to know who opened the book this year?
I can tell you this argument.
You can?
How?
She's opened the book!
Did you see that?
Astounding!
Remarkable!
I still say it was my turn.
It was not. I can't believe the prince is finally of age. It seems like only yesterday. Who's in here, too?
Hurry! They're coming! Did you finish sleeping?
Almost. I just have to do this part right over here.
Too late. We'll just have to hope the old queen doesn't notice.
She'll notice.
Would you please
know my son Valiant is 19 and a half years old, and the law decrees that we must consult ancient book of wit and wisdom. Now let me see. Page.
Why don't you put on your glasses? That might help.
Yes, Mother, of course. An excellent idea. Yes. Here's the page you want.
Speak up, Maxie. We can't hear you.
Yes, Mother, of course. Whereas and whensoever it comes to pass in the course of time, whenever that may be, whatsoever year happens to occur, on the proper day of the week and the ordained month of the suitable year, howsoever it may be or were, whatever the other concerns of the day.
Get to the point, will you?
Now, Granny, Pop has to read the whole thing. That's the law.
That's the law.
I like all the big words.
Me too.
Quiet!
Shh. Well, we do.
And one other concerns of the day, it shall come to pass when the eldest son of the royal family has attained the age of 10 9 1/2 years.
How old is that? 19 and a half, Ronald.
Oh.
And 1 1/2 years, he and his family shall consult the wisest gypsy in the kingdom.
Aha! Gypsy! That shouldn't be too difficult.
No, not at all.
But how do we know which gypsy is the wisest?
Because there's only one gypsy in the entire kingdom. Esmeralda Smythe.
Oh. We better call him, Papa.
Yes, of course.
Well, go on. Call her.
Yes. Mother?
Now what?
How do I call her?
Maxie, you're so helpless. I don't know what happened to this kingdom without me. I'll get her for you.
Thank you, Mother.
Yoo-hoo, Esmeralda! Yoo-hoo, Esmeralda! She'll be here in a minute.
What is that?
There she is. Abutoy, the great king, called Esmeralda, the lonely gypsy fortune teller.
Yes, I do. Wait, I did.
But can the humble gypsy go for the great king make the million? Shall I read the tea leaves or look at your palm? I shall read the lumps on your head, no? Ah, look at the charm, yes? A glimpse into the future, eh? Whatever you wish,
I can do.
Oh, Esmeralda, be quiet. Ah, is this you, ancient one?
Yes, of course it is me.
And we need to reveal the mystery of the law to my grandson.
My son is 19 and a half years old, and the ancient book of wit and wisdom says that...
Yes, I know that you must consult me.
Esmeralda, what is it I must do? What is the ancient tradition? Only you can tell me.
It is ordained that when each prince is 19 and a half years old, must journey to the neighboring kingdoms.
Journey!
Yes, now I remember. I did that myself.
But why must I take this journey, Esmeralda?
To find a real princess, a suitable bride. It is so written.
A bride?
A bride?
Yes. But if you find no suitable bride after 6 months, you must return home.
But why?
But why? It is so written that the prince must take the long journey.
But why?
Listen, Your Highness. I only repeat the laws. I do not explain them.
Thank you anyway, Esmeralda.
Yes, Esmeralda. Yes, Esmeralda. Thank you for, dropping it.
Anytime. Just call me. By the way, I have a cousin Samantha, just in case you don't find the princess you like. Say hello, Samantha.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, Samantha.
Let's get on with this. It's time for my nap. Then let this be gone.
I think it's fun!
You would. Why does she do that? It doesn't impress anybody. And it just makes a lot more dust.
I told you she'd notice.
We want to go on the journey too.
Of course we'll go with me. No prince can travel without his loyal squires.
Ah, yes, here it is. It is so decreed and declared that whensoever the eldest son of the family is conscripted.
Speak up, Maxie, we can't hear you.
Yes, Mother. According to the book, Valiant is his journey at once.
Oh, good!
Well, because that's what the book says, and I suppose it's what we must do.
Right. Go on, Valiant. Pack your things. You too, John and Ronald, and be quick about it.
Yes, Granny.
Yes, Madam.
Well, Mother, you have just enough time to take your nap before Valiant sets off on his journey.
Well, I hope I don't have any trouble falling asleep. It's always so noisy around here. Tell Donald and Ron to stop shouting, hear ye all the time. Then maybe, just maybe, I can get some sleep.
Oh, wait,
yes, Mother.
Are you sitting all along while you take your nap?
No, Buck! Well, son, are you ready for the journey?
Yes, Papa.
Valiant, take care of yourself.
Yes, Papa.
We will. Yes, well, yes, of course we will.
Come here, grandson. Now, on this trip, if you find a princess you really love, bring her here back to the castle.
Yes, Granny.
Remember, Valiant, you can only marry a true princess.
Yes, Granny.
And I am the only one in the family who knows the secret test.
Ooh,
yes.
Yes, only a princess of the true princessness can pass the secret test.
Now, Valiant, here's a map and a bag of gold for your travel expenses.
Thank you, Papa.
I have something for you, too. Here.
What is it, Granny? I won't have much time for reading.
I picked out a few proverbs from the Book of Wisdom.
A few?
Now, if you don't know what to do on your journey, just look at the list here, and it'll give you a little piece of wisdom to help you out.
Yes, Granny, I'll do that.
Your grandmother gave me the problems when I set out on my journey, too.
Aww.
Gee, that's nice.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
Well?
Well, what?
Well, go on, get started. You only have 6 months.
Yes, Granny. Goodbye, Papa.
Goodbye, Valiant.
Don't forget to write.
Yes, Papa.
Hi. Oh, I hope they don't get lost.
Now, Mother.
Or robbed.
Now, Mother.
Or get their feet wet. Don't get your feet wet. You'll catch a cold.
Oh, it's too late. Let's hope they have enough sense to come out of the rain.
Of course they do, Mother. Come, it's time for supper. We're having the creamed curry cucumber casserole that you like so much.
I don't like it. And if it isn't one thing around here, it's another.
Yes, Mother.
Come, Jackie. Come tell us a joke.
What about your song?
What?
No song.
One dragon, two giants, and a small band of robbers.
Yeah. Only rained once.
Yeah. You know, I always thought princess journeys were much more dangerous than this.
Me too.
Primus, look! The home of Princess Minerva the Marvelous of Marvy. The first princess! Are you nervous, Your Highness? Of course not.
Well, we are.
Donald, do you have the list of robbers Granny gave us?
Yes, right. Somewhere to... Oh, right here! Good. Now put them in a safe place.
Yes, Your Highness.
Well, I suppose I should knock. Right.
Ronald, you knock.
Yes, Your Highness.
That's enough, Ronald.
Yes, Your Highness. Well, I suppose nobody's home. Let's go.
Your extensive cacophony has disrupted the attitude of the atmosphere.
Huh? She means you make too much noise.
Oh.
I'm Prince Valiant. You must be Princess Minerva the Marvelous.
I am she.
How do you do?
I do quite remarkably well, thank you.
Well, that's good. I've been traveling to the neighboring kingdoms to meet people. Princesses, that is.
I have heard of your quest.
You have? That's wonderful. I mean, it saves you a lot of explanations, doesn't it?
I would assume it does. I understand you seek a suitable matrimonial prospect in order to enter the conjugal state.
What did she say?
She knows I'm looking for a wife.
Is that what she said? She sure talks funny.
Yes, I'm looking for a wife.
And I would assume you have come here to be myself as a potential candidate?
Potential candidate? Oh, you mean to see if you might be the one.
Precisely. Then perhaps we should determine whether there are any compatible interests between us.
Compatible interests? Oh, do we need to see if we have anything in common?
Exactly.
Well, let's see. I like to swim, take long rides on my horse, and I like fishing. Do you like fishing?
Not particularly.
Oh. Well, I like music.
I enjoy certain varieties of musical expression myself.
That's great. You know the song? Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream.
Merry, 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 life is but a dream.
I'm not familiar with that particular melody.
You're not? Then what kinds of music do you like?
Operatic music is usually my preference, although some of the lighter operas are not exactly enjoyable.
I see.
Of course, I devote a considerable amount of time to the absorption of literary knowledge.
Donald, wake up! You mean you like to read a lot?
Indeed. Do you like to read?
Well, sometimes.
I enjoy studies of an archaeological nature, although biological and zoological research are often quite stimulating.
Really? Well, I think we better get going.
Of course, my favorite philosophers are the transcendental behaviorist determinists.
Mine too. Well, I really think we better get going.
The most restful reading is always found in mathematics theory.
Math! Donald, get me out of here!
What are you doing, Ernest?
Look at the list of problems Brady gave us.
Look, the square root of -1. Isn't it beautiful?
Yes. Guys, hurry! Here's what your highest read.
If you're hungry, eat a turkey sandwich!
No, no!
And logarithms, tables and tables of them!
Guys!
And trigonometry formulas!
Guys!
And geometric theorems!
Guys!
Oh, here's one. When it becomes necessary to leave, say goodbye!
Goodbye, madam.
Oh yes, goodbye, Prince Valiant. Square root of -2. Beautiful, magnificent.
I could never marry Princess Minerva. I know. Never know what she was talking about, ever.
She was always talking like math and books and science and reading and zoology. That's the truth.
I am smart with books. But yeah, besides, she'd have so many books in the castle, we wouldn't have room for any of them.
Yeah, that's true. So, where to next?
I don't know. We must leave her home with Princess Diana, didn't we? Hi, I'm Prince Valiant. You must be Princess Diana Damon.
That's me!
How do you do?
I've
been traveling through neighboring kingdoms to meet people.
Well, that's so true. Travel is pretty expensive these days. Why, only last year, a dozen princes came knocking on the gate, and then no one came for months.
Thank you.
Do you like to dance, Prince Valiant?
Sometimes.
Okay, I love to dance. I can dance all day.
Could you?
I dance very well, don't I?
Of course you do.
Well, come on, dance with me.
Well, I don't think.
Oh, you get so loud, isn't it?
Squires!
So much in common.
We do?
Oh yes, you should hear
do you?
Here, Aspen's night, and I'll sing for you. Tra la la! Tis the month of May! Tra la la!
Is that how angels sing, Your Highness? I hope not.
Tra la la!
That's very nice, Princess Diana.
Oh, thank you. Do you want me to sing another song?
No, no, not right now. We must be going.
Oh, so soon? But you just got here.
Yes, I know, but.
Well.
Well, what?
Am I a the one?
The one?
Your chosen bride.
Good. I'm sorry, Princess Diana. I can't answer your question right now.
Oh.
So, don't call us. We'll call you.
You will?
If you are the one. And farewell to you.
Farewell, Princess Diana. It's glad you come back. I'll show you my tattoo. See?
That's very nice, Princess Diana.
Farewell.
That singing. I can never marry her. She giggles all the time.
Except when she's singing.
Or dancing.
Besides, she'd never get along to her grandmother.
Never. Yeah.
You better work! Wow.
Searching for.
Yes, I know that too. You're searching for a suitable bride.
Yes, I am.
I suppose you haven't found one yet.
No, haven't.
I didn't think so. After all, you haven't met me until now.
No, I haven't.
And after all, I am the most beautiful girl in the world.
Yes, you are quite beautiful.
Yes, I know.
Do you like horseback
riding? Riding? Heavens no. Always a stranger to my hands.
Then do you like reading, perhaps?
Reading? Oh, no. It always makes my eyes so red.
Then what do you do to pass your time?
What do I do? It should be obvious what I do. This is what I do.
You look at yourself in the mirror all day.
Naturally. Where else would I look?
Well, I mean, there's many other things to see.
Nonsense!
She moves it. She really looks at herself all day.
Great. I must study myself to make sure I am always as beautiful as I can possibly be.
Yes, that's true. Donald, get me out of here!
What? Coming to me? Dude,
look at the list of Proverbs.
The terrible and tragic loss would be to the entire world if my great beauty were to fall. I must again look at myself all the time. It is my duty.
Yes, I can see. The only way to deal with extreme conceit is to agree with it.
Aha! What does that mean?
You'll see. Yes, I can see that your duty is most important, Princess.
Yes. I owe it to the world.
Yes, you must.
I'm so grateful that you want to take me out. I cannot forgive myself. I must think of the world.
Yes, you must.
I realize this must be difficult for you. Naturally, you would have chosen me to be your bride. But what man who has gazed so upon my face could naturally resist me? However, you must bear your face to the of the because I can never be your or anyone. You must do that yourself. As thou art, try to forget me.
I shall try, Princess.
Farewell, Princess Valiant. Such loveliness, such a time requires much sleep.
Indeed it does.
Resign yourself about being able to not marry her?
Oh, I think I'll manage all right.
Yeah. I didn't know there's so many strange princesses out there, Your Highness.
Yeah, I agree. I'm beginning to think I'm never gonna find one that I want to marry.
So, where are you now?
he's still the strongest of Ovia?
Right, good to meet you. Who are the little guys?
I beg your pardon?
Your friends here, who are they?
This is Donald and Ronald Dunst, squires.
How are you, squires?
Body battle!
Great!
Princess Stella.
Hey, why don't you call me Amazon? All my friends do.
All right, Amazon. I've been traveling through the neighboring kingdoms to meet.
Oh yeah, I know all about you. You're looking for Brian, right?
Yes, I am.
I think that's great, just great. Most princes just sit around at home these days. They never go out and fight dragons or anything like that. It's good to meet a prince who's not afraid to leave home.
Thank you.
So you're looking for a bride?
Yes, I am.
And I suppose you've come here to see if maybe I'm the one for you?
Yes, that's true.
Great, sit. You want to wrestle?
What?
Aw, come on. Don't be scared, I won't hurt you.
I don't usually wrestle princesses.
Why not? I can wrestle as well as anybody.
No, I believe you.
You can win, come on!
You can do it, your highness, come on!
Quiet!
There, see, I told you I could wrestle as well as anybody.
You did mention it.
Wow, is she strong?
You said it, Shorties. Hey, come on, Prince, get up, will you? Here, I'll give you a hand.
Wow,
is she strong?
How about some weightlifting?
Perhaps some other time.
Aw, come on.
All right, Princess.
Go on, Highness. Give it a try.
You first.
You can do it, Your Highness. Come on.
I can't seem to.
Here, I'll show you. You're doing it all wrong.
I am?
Sure. It's easy when you know how. Watch.
Wow. Is she strong?
Yeah. Donald, how can we get out of this?
Well, listen, Prince. It's great meeting you.
Thank you.
I hope you find yourself a bride. You and I are right for each other.
No.
That's for sure.
No.
I can never marry a man I can only beat when I wrestle with him.
I can understand that, Princess.
Well, see you around, Prince. Bye, Shorties.
Bye.
Whew. Wow, was she strong?
He already said that.
Oh.
What could I have done?
Nothing.
Right.
Nothing.
Yeah.
So? Here, let's look at the map.
Not sure.
No, where are we?
Well,
here's where the forest starts. Yeah.
I wonder where this forest is.
Look at that!
That's
nothing. Oh, sorry. It's a little scary. Sorry, it's a forest. And
what is that?
I think it's a rose bush.
Maybe it's magic.
You bet.
Uh-oh.
Well.
Wait, someone's coming.
Well, Ashley, watch out for the...
Ow!
Storms. Oh, maybe it's Mrs. Yes, I'm a prince. How did you know?
Well, all good fairies have certain powers.
That's what I've heard, at least, I think.
Are you a good fairy?
Absolutely, definitely, and positive. One of the good, if I can say so myself.
Certified and licensed to practice good deeds in 7 kingdoms.
How can we tell they're telling the truth?
Our references, going back 5 centuries.
Oh. We can go back further if you'd like.
No, no. 5 centuries is just fine. I beg your pardon?
Are you here to awaken famous Sleeping Beauty?
No. Perhaps if she's sleeping, we should awake her. We could come back sometime. When do you think she'll wake up?
Oh, in about 100 years.
100 years?
I think that's longer than 6 months.
Yeah, I think that's longer than 6 months.
Yeah, maybe.
I don't know. Yeah, I only have 6 months to find a bride, and 100 years is certainly longer than that.
Oh, so we got to
kiss her. I don't even know her.
Oh, that doesn't matter.
It doesn't?
Not if you're the right prince.
Have many other princes tried to...
Oh, yes, lots and lots.
And what happened to them?
Oh, they failed.
I see. Well, Donald, how can we get out of this?
Oh, here.
Avoid kissing a princess.
princess was under a spell before you were properly introduced.
Well, thanks for all your help, but I...
Oh, excuse us, Your Highness, but I think another princess is on his way. Never a dull moment around here.
Keep us in mind. Bye now.
Just look at those thorns. Don't touch it again. I'm sure clean around here. So, where are we now? I don't know. I think it must be near the home of Princess Fury's father. How can you tell? Well, it's kind of spotless. Excuse me.
Did you wipe your feet?
No.
Go back and wipe your feet.
Alright. We're looking for Princess Purity.
I am Princess Purity.
How do you do?
Did they wipe their feet?
I don't know.
You told them.
I'm sure they didn't wipe their feet. Did you wipe your feet?
We did.
No.
Look at that.
What?
What is it?
Dirt.
Oh no.
Destroy that dirt directly.
Yes, Princess Purity.
Dirt has been destroyed. Good. Can I hear a say?
I'm Prince Valiant, and...
Disgusting!
I beg your pardon?
Look at all these detestable cobwebs. Who is responsible for cleaning this floor?
They are.
Clean and scour and sanitize it immediately.
Yes, Princess Purity.
Don't hit that corner up there. Watch it. You missed a spot.
Yes, Princess Purity.
Well, Prince Valiant.
I'm Donald, and I'm Ronald,
and we're twins!
I'm Mop, she's Glow, and that's Shine.
That's not right. I'm Glow, she's Mop, and that's Shine.
No, we're Shine, she's Mop, and that's Glow.
That's what I said.
No, it's not. You said...
Now wait a minute.
Keep scrubbing.
Yes, Princess Purity.
Well, Prince Valiant, I can only give you a tiny moment of time. I have numerous obligations and duties, as you can see.
Yes, I can see.
I've heard of your quest for pride. I wish you good fortune, however, I too have a mission. And my mission is to take presents of any personal fault or concerns.
And what is your mission, Princess?
I'm devotedly dedicated to the destruction of dirt, dust, and
debris. I see.
Oh, I might consider a future alliance with the Princely Paragon of Preparation and Perfection, if there is such a person. Which I doubt, but for now I must continue the never-ending battle against dirt, dust, and debris.
I can understand that, Princess.
Come on now, it's time to walk the sidewalk again. Then, we'll clean the alley.
Yes, Princess Purity.
Be sure to wipe your feet on the way out.
That was short, man. I mean, I don't know how I like those people.
I mean, they're kind of slaves.
Oh my god!
Oh,
hello? Esmeralda.
Greetings, Prince Valiant.
Say hello, Samantha.
Hi.
How did you find us?
Oh, I have my ways.
Have you found yourself a bride?
No, not yet. Don't forget about my cousin Samantha.
Oh, I
have forgotten.
Oh, I have forgotten.
She's willing and able.
Like Samantha.
Oh, yes.
And she's descended from a long line of gypsy kings.
I am?
Quiet!
He'll keep that in mind.
You do that.
Say goodbye, Samantha.
Bye.
Farewell, Esmeralda.
The Belton's calling.
Ah, boy!
It's kind of scary.
Did you put something in her bag?
I don't know.
Well, let's see. We're right about here.
Where is here?
The Kingdom of Hypochondria. And that must be Princess Allegica. What? Greetings, Princess. I'm Prince Valiant. How are you?
Oh, I've been better. Thank you.
Do you have a bad cold, Princess?
No, I'm just allergic to things.
What kind of things?
Oh, you name it. I'm allergic. Go on, name something.
Dill beans. Potato pancakes.
Achoo!
Gee, that's too bad.
Well, I'm pretty used to it.
Isn't there a
Wow.
Wow.
And 130
horses. Wow.
Wait, why not?
I'm allergic to all their medicines, too.
I see.
So I just have to stay in a hyperallergized room most of the time.
I see.
Is your castle hyperallergized?
I don't know. I don't think so.
You'll have to take care of that before I can move in. And if you have a moat, you'll have to get rid of it. I'm allergic to water. And if you have any windows, you'll have to break all of them.
I see.
And you'll have to remodel the kitchen too. And leave the box. I just gave you a list.
A list?
And I never traveled anywhere without my 47 doctors and 138 nurses. And they all need private rooms. Is your castle big enough?
I don't know. I don't think so. I have to ask my grandmother.
You'll have to take care of that. You'll just tell me when your castle is ready.
Yes, I'll do that. Right, princess.
Masculinitudinous.
What?
issues to discuss with you.
What? She wants to ask me some questions.
First, mostly, are you a biological participant in the earthly socio-economic classification known as a prince?
Yes. I'm a prince.
Excellent. Sasha, begin the process of teleportation immediately. Subject in question fills all requirements for us to begin our mission.
Excuse me.
Well, what is it? We only have a brief window of opportunity in the relative time-space continuum.
Yes, I realize that, but...
What? The warp drive is repaired? Till 11 of 9, I'll begin the process of teleportation immediately.
Excuse me.
Pardon me, Morph. Subject attempts communication. What is it?
Who are you?
I thought you knew. I'm Sabrina of Zebron from the Zynite Galaxy. And these are my faithful followers, the weird crawling Xenons.
Oh.
And I've chosen you to be my significant marital unit.
What? She wants to marry me. Oops.
The compatibility fix data indicates you are ideal to transmingle into our tribal specifications.
But I can't just fly into space.
Of course you can. People do it all the time.
Happens all the time.
Cool.
Look, Morph, I'm proceeding as rapidly as possible. Subject so shows signs of resistance. I will use the Stingray Rapper Zapper if necessary.
Ah, the Rapper Zapper!
I volunteer as tribute.
What?
I volunteer to go on your place. I love to travel, and I've always wanted to see the Zynite Galaxy.
Well, Ronald, if you're sure.
Yes, Your Highness.
You've been a loyal and dependable friend, Ronald.
Thank you.
What the Andromeda? Oh, do you also hold the earthly socio-economic classification known as a prince?
No! Even better! He's a squire!
Morph, change in plans. We've secured a different subject. We must teleportize immediately back to the mothership.
Whoa, Ronald, if you're sure. This is gonna be so fun!
What? The Andromeda influence is lifting? That means the magnetron device is already scrambled! The Bordotrons can now penetrate our protective screensavers!
Farewell, Ronald. Farewell, Princess Sabrina.
May the Prince be with you, brother.
And also with you!
So, where to next? We're going home.
Home?
Why?
I'm tired of traveling. And besides, you know what Granny wrote on the list of proverbs. If you feel like coming home, come home. It's right there.
But Your Highness!
We're going home, and that's all there is to it. Oh, don't be so glum, Ronald. We've had a fine adventure.
I know. I'm just sorry it has to end.
Come alive, come alive, come and light your light, let it burn so bright, reaching up to the sky, and it's open wide, you're electrified, and the world becomes a fantasy, and you're all that you could ever be, cause you're dreaming with your eyes wide open, and you know you can't go back again to the world that you were living in.
You didn't find
one
princess you liked?
No, Bruni.
Not one?
What about sweet little
Theosophus?
No, Bruni.
Did you like her?
No, Bruni.
Barbara Big Mouth?
She's a dear girl.
No, Bruni.
I remember one. What about Henrietta the Hungry?
I've always liked her.
Wonderful actor.
I don't like her.
You don't?
No, and I'm sure Valiant didn't like her either.
Well...
You see, he didn't like her at all.
All right. Well, son, it's good to have you home anyway.
Thank you, Papa.
And one interesting story about Ronald. I hope he enjoys his time in outer space.
But he still doesn't have a bride.
Well, the 6 months are almost up, Mother. He'll just have to stay at home and hope the bride comes to him.
That's the law.
That's the law.
I know. But how many real princesses go wandering about the countryside knocking on gates?
Not very many.
Right. We could wait 100 years and not one real princess would ever knock on our gate. Not one.
Ah! There's someone knocking on the gate!
There is?
Don't answer it!
Why not?
It might be a witch.
That's true.
Or a goblin.
It could be a fire-breathing dragon.
Or a gigantic gargoyle.
Or a hairy hippogriff.
Might be a princess.
Of course not.
Open the gate, Mama. Please.
Oh, I don't know.
Gee, maybe it's a stray dog.
Well, all right. I'd hate to leave anyone out in this weather, especially a stray dog. Open the gate. You'll be sorry, Maxie.
Now, Mother.
Gracious, it's two drowned girls. They could have gone through the back door instead of dragging on the mud through the clean hallway.
Yo, who are you?
Why, yes, I am.
You certainly don't look like a princess.
I should say not. Oh,
so do I.
Did you follow my grandson here?
I beg your pardon?
I know your type. You heard about my grandson's quest. You came here, pretending to be some princess, hoping he'd marry you.
Madam, my mistress knows nothing of your grandson or his quest. Furthermore, she is not pretending to be a princess. She is a princess, a real one.
I like her! She talked back to your grandmother.
Well, my dear, it doesn't rather strange for a princess to be wandering about in this weather, unattended and with no luggage.
Of course it is strange, and I agree. Certainly I do not ordinarily travel this way. I'm Princess Olivia, daughter of King Beauregard of Bolivia.
Indeed, I know him.
Well, I don't.
Lady Hildegard and myself are on our way to the Kingdom of Qing. I'm to marry King Ming Ling of Qing in a month's time.
Marry?
This evening we were caught in the rain, and then we were attacked by highwaymen. Lady Hildegard and I were separated from the guards who escorted us when we ran into the woods to hide. After a while, we realized that we were lost. We saw your castle lights and followed them through the rain. We knocked on your gate, expecting some degree of courtesy and hospitality. My father sends the visitors of the royal rank when they visit our home. If you do not care to have us stay, we shall now go and seek shelter elsewhere. Come, Hildegard.
Wait, please.
What is it?
I'm Prince Valiant, Princess Olivia. This is my father, King Maximilian, and my grandmother, Queen Maud.
How do you do?
Please forgive my family for seeming so rude. Of course you're welcome to stay.
Yes, of course.
My family is somewhat overwrought. I have just returned from a long quest in which I was searching for a princess to make my bride.
And did you find her? Your bride?
No, I did not. Although I met and saw many princesses, not one of them shared the same qualities of dignity, pride, and honor which I've just seen in you.
Thank you.
You are a real princess.
Of course she is.
We'll just see about that.
Well.
Will you stay?
Yes, Prince Valiant, I will stay.
I'm Donald Ducks, squire for the prince. You know, someday I'll be a knight and have my own, my very own suit of armor.
Really?
Oh, really, dear.
Take my word for it, she's after me.
No, Mother, she seems to be a very nice girl.
Grace Lane. You want to drag in some rest with 20 or 30 giants?
Oh my, you are brave.
Bad average, I'd say.
We must make our guests comfortable for the night. They're tired and should rest.
Yes, of course, Valiant.
This way, Princess Olivia. This way, we hope her.
Come, Mother. Let us make arrangements for our guests.
Arrangements, indeed. My grandson seems quite taken with this princess. What's her name? If she is a real princess, which I doubt. But we'll just see about that. I'll give her the real princess chess. Now come along, all of you. I'm going to need your help.
Yes, I am.
I see.
Your Book of Wit and Wisdom says that your chosen bride must be a true princess.
Yes, she must.
And that she must pass a certain test.
Yes, that's true.
What is the test?
I don't know. Only my grandmother knows.
And no one has passed this test so far?
No, princess. In fact, not even one princess has even taken the test so far.
Oh? Why not?
Because until very recently, there was no princess I wished to marry.
And you found her now? A princess you wish to marry?
Perhaps I have. I don't know.
And who is she, this princess?
Can't you guess?
No.
It is you.
Me?
Yes.
Oh, but I'm to marry King Ming.
Yes, I know. Do you love him very much?
Love him? I've never met him.
You haven't? Then why are you going to marry him? How can your father wish you to marry a man you've never met, a man you don't care about?
My father did not wish me to marry King Ming.
He didn't? Then why?
There was a great famine in my father's kingdom, and the people were poor and hungry. My father gave them all his gold so they could buy food from the neighboring provinces.
That was very generous and noble of him.
But without gold, other kingdoms threatened to invade, and my father had no gold for ships or soldiers.
Then what did he do?
King Ming offered my father 100 bags of gold, but only if I would become the Queen of Qing. Of course my father refused the offer.
I should think so.
But I insisted he allow me to marry King Ming.
But why?
I was the only way to save my father's kingdom. He needs the 100 bags of gold. Besides, what else can I do? No other king or prince would want to marry a princess who was so poor.
That's not true. I'm certain many princes would want to marry gold or no gold.
Really?
Take myself, for example. Now, the laws of my kingdom say they must marry a true princess.
Yes, I know, but...
The laws say nothing whether this princess must be rich or poor, only that she must be real.
Yes, but...
So you see, I could be a prince who could possibly marry you.
Yes, I see, but...
Princess Olivia, would you like to take the test?
You mean the test to see if I'm a real princess?
Yes, and when you pass the test.
When I pass the test? Don't you mean if?
No, when.
I'm not very clever with numbers and books and sorts. I could fail the test if it's very difficult.
You won't fail.
But I promised to marry King Ming.
A promise your father didn't want you to make. Don't you want to take the test?
Yes, I do, but my father...
Don't worry about your father. I'll be glad to give your father as much gold as he needs.
You would?
Yes, we have lots of it. And don't worry about King Ming. My father will take care of him.
Oh, Prince Valiant, I don't know what to say. In the course of a few minutes, you may have just changed my entire life.
I hope so. I'll go tell Granny that I want you to take your test. Will you excuse me?
Certainly, Prince Valiant. Oh, I can hardly believe it. Maybe I won't have to marry King Ming after all. Maybe. Oh, I hope I can pass the test. I really hope so. Prince Valiant is so noble and so gracious. And so attractive.
And so, Granny, I would like Princess Olivia to take the test.
I figured as much, grandson.
You did? I only decided a minute ago.
Well, I could see which way the wind was turning when she first got here.
You could?
Sure, I may be old, but I'm not stupid.
I never said you were, Granny.
Don't worry, everything's all arranged.
For the test?
Right.
Thank you, Granny.
Don't worry, that's what Granny's for. Now, where is Maxie? He's always wandering off somewhere.
I think Papa went to the kitchen to get a glass of milk.
Ah, thank you. Put that mattress on top and I'll be back in a minute.
Donald, I just told Granny that I want Princess Olivia to take the test.
You did? Then she's the one you...
Yes, and Granny has already arranged for the test to take place.
Really? When?
Why? I don't know. I forgot to ask. Tomorrow, I suppose. Well, I'll go tell Princess Olivia.
Well, what do you know about that? It's Finley found a princess he really likes.
What is the test the princess has to take?
No one knows except the old queen.
Well,
sure hope she passes it.
So do I.
Wait, why?
Well, because...
You'd stay with her if she married the prince, right?
Yes, of course I would.
That's nice. that's great. You're nice.
Thank you.
I mean...
You're nice too.
I am? Yeah. Oh, great.
You can call me Hildy if you like.
I can? Say, Hildy, do you like to go fishing?
What?
Well, Prince Valiant always says it's good to find a wife.
What?
A girl, a friend who likes you the same thing as you.
Well, I do actually.
Oh, I like baking. Do you like baking?
Oh yes, I like to bake. I can make a chocolate cake that melts in your mouth.
Yummy!
I'll make
make your chocolate cake sometime soon.
You will? Oh, good!
Hurry up! What's taking so long?
What's taking so long? Run along! I'm going to talk to Maxie.
Mother, what's going on?
Well, be quiet a minute, Maxie, and I'll explain it to you.
Oh no! I forgot my hat! I'll be right back!
Mother, what are those mattresses here for?
They're part of the test.
What are you testing? To see if she's allergic to feathers?
No. To see, the only way to test if a girl's a real princess is to test her sensitivity.
Mother, I don't understand this at all.
Well, be quiet a minute, Maxie, and I'll explain it to you.
Yes, Mother.
Now, do you see this?
Mother, it's a pea.
I know. It's a dry pea. Now I'm going to put it under the bottom mattress.
And then what, Mother? Please explain.
Well, when you see, when this princess, what's her name, goes to bed tonight, she'll be very tired. Now, if in the morning she says that the bed was uncomfortable and that she couldn't sleep, then we know she is indeed a real princess and worthy to marry into the family. But if she said that she slept well, then we know she isn't the right girl for Valen to marry.
And that's the test?
It sure is.
But isn't it awfully difficult?
Of course it is difficult. But if Valiant wants to marry this princess, she'll have to pass the test. Like the women in the family for the past 500 years.
Well, I sure do hope she does pass the test. Otherwise, Valiant will be very disappointed.
That is true. Now I'm going to put it under the
bottom. Could you put it under that one?
No, under this one. That's the way it has to be. Now, let's go find what's her name and put her off to bed.
Yes, Mother.
Hey, see me. We're in. Now, I know what the secret test is supposed to be. I better find Prince Brownie so we can tell him. And then he'll tell Princess Olivia. And maybe he'll have his father knight me for this. I'll be Sir Donald Dunce. I better hurry. Thank you.
tired. I wish I knew what the test was supposed to be. And how can I take a test while I'm asleep? That's the part I don't understand. Certainly is quiet around here. There's nothing to stop me from going to sleep. Maybe I will if I stop worrying about the test. Maybe the old queen will ask me about my dreams in the morning. Maybe that's the test, to see if I dream about the right thing. Well, if that's true, then I'd better try to sleep. I wish.
Makes us all feel much safer.
Oh, yes, indeed. It certainly does.
Oh, hello, Donald.
Hi. I can't sleep. I'm going to be so happy in the morning. So is Prince Valiant. I'm going to be a knight, and he's going to finally have a wife.
Donald.
Hi. Lady Hooker, can't you sleep either?
No, I can't.
Why?
I'm so worried about the test. The princess was so tired last night, she could have slept just about anywhere. How can she take a test if she's asleep?
Well, there's not much we can do now except just wait.
Well, what else can we do?
We can go to the kitchen and have a snack.
Snack? Somebody's snack?
That's a good idea.
Or a big peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Peanut butter?
And jelly? With a huge glass of milk.
And jelly. Me too. Snacks for everyone.
Too bad. So you didn't sleep at all?
No, I'm afraid not.
Great!
Donald! Granny, what about the test?
Oh, she passed it.
I passed the test.
Right. But what did I do?
You passed the test.
But how?
Well, you'll see, my dear.
No, I'll tell her, Maxie.
All right.
You see, with all those mattresses, there's...
Well, who cares how she passed it? I just care that she passed it.
Oh, I almost forgot. Better take all that stuff out before anyone notices.
No, Prince Valen is
home. Prince doesn't have a choice. Meet me in the other room and I can do some fishing. No wonder she couldn't sleep. I wonder if her could sleep with all this stuff on here. Well, maybe I'll also get some chocolate cake.
Well, let's get to bed. I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm tired.
Later today, we'll plan the wedding. Welcome to the family, Princess Olivia.
And soon, I'll be a knight!
Yes, you are indeed a true princess.
Thank you.
Hooray.
Now let's all get some sleep.
Valentine just went in the crystal ball.
Oh well, I guess that's just the way it goes.
But of course, I have another idea.
You do?
Let's go visit my friend Cassandra.
The fairy godmother?
She did amazing things for Cinderella. Maybe she can do something for you.
That sounds like fun.
Then let us be gone. Ah, die!
I imagine you're tired.
Yes, but I'm happy.
I'll see you later. Try to rest.
I will. Well, now that the test is over, maybe I can get some sleep after all. Oh, that lumpy bed. Maybe I should just pull one of the mattresses off and sleep on that. And maybe, oh, I'm so tired I could just sleep on them all and never even feel the lumps. Well, I'll try it anyway. Ouch. Oh, so just as lumpy. Well, we'll just have to take a look. Maybe there's something in one of the mattresses. I wonder. My goodness, what's this? A dried pea? Well, no wonder I couldn't sleep. I wonder how a dried pea got there. Well, maybe now I can sleep at last. Oh yes, that's much better. No lumps at all.